Just a quick little follow-up video from the mailbag a couple of weeks ago where I got these little power supplies, which are pretty obviously reclaimed from something. One of the most likely suggestions was that they were overstocked and then stripped out and sold. These are 110 volt AC in, at least I assume they might take higher voltages, I haven't tried that, to 5 volts DC out at 2 amps. So I'm going to just give them a quick test and see if they can actually do that. During the mailbag video, I gave them a bit of a test, but I had a janky setup and I had some voltage drop in it and stuff. So we'll give her a shot and test the three of them. Here is my test setup. I've got 110 volt AC input connected there, and I have a USB female output. It's 5 volts, so that's legit, right? And I'm using 18 gauge stranded wire here, which should be more than enough for 2 amps, especially at that length. The source of the wire that I'm using is reclaimed from a couple of ATX power supplies. So these are rated high enough for a short distance especially. So I shouldn't have any significant amount of loss in that distance. It's probably going to be more loss in the USB connector, but that is what it is. And to measure them, I will use my little load here, which can draw well over 2 amps and has built-in voltmeter all at the same time. So that's handy. And I'm just going to use the same rig and resolder it onto the other two just to test them and make sure that they work. So here we go. There's power. From here on, I'm just going to zoom in on this guy because that's the only way I can get it to not flicker, or at least not flicker so much. So right now it's pulling about 500 milliamps, 480 milliamps. And it's showing 5.1 volts, so it's not sagging at all. So there's 1 amp. Still solid at 5.1 volts. Oh, that's watts. Doesn't matter. Amp, 1.7 amps. Still 5.1 volts. 0.6. What does it do when we get up to 2 amps? 1.7, 1.8, still at 5.1 volts and solid. 1.9, still at 5.1 and solid. So that's looking like it's going to live up to its rating here. 0.945, and it just dropped out and reset. Let's crank that down a little bit. 1.86, and it looks like it's come back up. Yeah, so I'm just going to sneak up on that slower now till it drops out. 1.93, 5.0 volts, so it's starting to drop off there. That's pretty close. 0.94, 4.9 volts. Fan just kicked in because my heatsink's getting hot, 4.8. So there's where it's starting to drop off. And if I sneak up a little bit higher, I think it's going to drop out on me again. Oops, wrong way. 0.95, 0.96, 1.97, and it's dropped out. Within 30 milliamps of its reading. Well, that's cool. So I'm going to crank this load back down again to about 1 amp. And I think, just for shits and giggles, I'm going to plug this into 220 volts. I have adapters and things. Hang on. Okay, let me just go on record as saying this is a bad idea. But that's never stopped me before. It should stop you. Caveat emptor or whatever. So this is just a straight up transformer, 120 volts AC into 220 volts AC out with the standard European plug on it. This is a European style nightlight that I've hacked apart and put a piece of wire into. That is a couple of knockoff Wago connectors. This is a 110 volt North American AC outlet connected to the 220 volt AC output of that. Here's where the bad ideas start compounding. That is in fact 230 some volts on a North American plug. Very bad idea. Here is one of these power supplies still connected, and I'm not going to use this thing because it may or may not blow up. I'm going to use my cheap ass charger doctor. Pull that meter out of the way just in case. Yeah, well, nothing for it but the doing. Okay, it hasn't blown up yet. That's a good sign. That says 0 amps, which it should. And 5.17 volts. It works. Okay. Let's try it with the load. I'll zoom in enough so that it's not too flickery. So 1.09 amps. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And our output voltage, I'm going to assume, is still, yeah, 5.1 volts. So it works just as well on the European voltage. Okay. And it kicks out right there, which I expected it to. But I'm not going to leave that connected for any longer than I have to, just to prove that it actually works on universal world voltages. Okay, I'm going to clear this dangerous thing out of the way and move the wiring from there over onto the next one of these power supplies and carry on with my testing. Okay, there's the second one soldered down. The circuit layout is slightly different. Two of them have this layout over here, and one of them has this layout. You know, it's the big capacitor is different. The MOV is sitting at a different angle, and this capacitor as well. This transformer looks a little bit different. This dual diode, I think it's labeled D7. The labeling is the same, but it's got a bit of heat shrink over its heatsink tab. So that's slightly different. The numbering on the bottom corner of the board is slightly different. Right, the capacitor, they're probably just from different batches. These capacitors are a different brand than these ones over here. Little things like that. Nothing that should prevent them from operating properly, though. So here we go with number two. Let's turn that down a little bit. Actually, no, it lit up at 1.8. That's fine. 5.1 volts. Let's just leave it on voltage and slowly crank up the current until we see the voltage start dropping off. Get my finger out of the way of the fan just in case it decides to start. Oh, there we go. 3.6, 3.7. That is 1.86 amps. Which is pretty close to the other one, 1.7 amps, 3.4. So that's where it kind of falls off the cliff. Let's just reduce the current right back. So there's 4 volts. We'll get it up to about, well, that's a pretty sharp drop off. 5.0. Just slowly, yeah, right there's where it's dropping off. 1.86. So what is that? 150 milliamps below its rated 2 amp output. That's not bad. Okay, I'll just quickly solder up the third one and see what it does. Oh, there's our fan. Okay, and there is the third one soldered up. Okay, power on. What's happening here? Let's crank this down. Oh, this one's intermittent. Interesting. Let's crank that power much lower. This one seems to be intermittent. Did I screw something up here? I wonder if that little solder ball there that shouldn't be there is my culprit. All I don't see anything else obvious in my soldering on the board, so let's see what happens now. No, it looks like it's still not happy. I wonder if there's... Oh, it might just be a dud. These might be factory seconds. Who knows? This might just be a pays your money and takes your chances situation. Let me just plug this little LED into there. Yeah, that doesn't look very happy, does it? Looks like it's trying, but then it's shutting down. Oh, wait. Did I just have a bad connection? Let's just not touch it. No, it's not happy. Huh, there's something going on in the output stage of that. Because it can obviously generate 5 volts, but it can't sustain it. I'm not sure how deep I want to go into troubleshooting this thing. Certainly not for this video. This was just intended to be a quick video to take a look at these little power supplies. And I got 2 out of 3 that work, and they cost $2.94 each. I got them at auction on eBay. Well, approximately $2.94. I think one of them was cheaper. But, I don't know. For two 5-volt, 2-amp power supplies that do work, and one that I'm going to have to do a little bit of investigation on, I think that's still a decent enough deal, especially what they would normally cost. Anyway, thanks for watching. Just, like I said, just a quick little video here. I will talk to you later.